I am Suzanne Scarlatta, and I'm giving a video presentation of the highlights of our paper by Sahu et al. In protein science. So what our lab is interested in is cell signaling through phospholipase C. And here is just a cartoon of the signaling pathway of phospholipase C, and it's a G protein activated protein enzyme. And what it does is it'll respond to extracellular signals like dopamine and acetylcholine to release intercellular calcium, which then causes the activation of a lot of calcium-sensitive enzymes. But several years ago, our lab found that phospholipase C also likes to be in the cytoplasm. And in the cytoplasm, it binds with another protein called C3PO, which is an octamer consisting of trax and translin. And what C3PO does is it plays a role in nucleic acid modifications, and most notably, it promotes RNA-induced gene silencing. So what we're interested in is, what are the parameters? How is it the PLC regulates C3PO to change RNA-induced silencing? So in this paper, what we did, and I'm gonna just change the slide over. So what we first did is we wanted to find the specificity of C3PO, because C3PO, it binds nucleotides, but we had no idea if it preferred any types of specific microRNAs. And if it did, then that would really change what genes would want to be silenced over other genes. So we used a method called CellX, and then we did some theoretical calculations, and we find that C3PO likes to bind to RNAs or nucleic acids that have like these stem loop structures or a mix between single-stranded and double-stranded. We then looked at binding with some of these proteins, and what we found, and I'll just go through these very quickly, is that basically what C3PO does is it binds fairly non-specifically in sequence. It has a structural specificity, but what it does is nucleic acids that have a lot of AT character, it hydrolyzes much more quickly than nucleic acids with GC character. Now, when PLC binds to C3PO, C3PO no longer hydrolyzes things that rapidly. Okay, what PLC seems to be doing is it blocks either oligonucleotide entry or exit out of C3PO, and in doing so, it inhibits C3PO activity. So, and then what we also found, and this was, we'd observed earlier that only certain genes are affected by PLC binding to C3PO. And here what we found is the genes that are affected by C3PO are the genes that C3PO hydrolyzes much more slowly. I'm sorry, the mRNAs, C3PO hydrolyzes much more slowly. And that's because PLC will not allow the binding and exit of these oligonucleotides in and out of C3PO. Whereas microRNAs that are hydrolyzed much more rapidly are not affected by PLC binding, because PLC binds to C3PO a little bit with a similar kind of affinity. And so the whole thermodynamic process is described in the paper. So that's it. Thank you.